And over the next few weeks, we're going to be looking at what it is we believe and where we place our faith and our hope and where we believe God is active in our lives. And one of the things that we believe in, if we'll use those words, is our system with our pastors. And we have what's called an appointment cabinet. And I hope that our appointive cabinet, our bishop, our district superintendents, that they come into prayerful discernment when it comes to appointments of your pastor. And we heard a couple weeks ago that Pastor Antoinetta will be starting up a Hispanic ministry, actually a multicultural ministry, here in the greater Las Vegas area. And we're excited about that, and we will continue to pray for her over the next few weeks, up to her last day with us, and then on after that. But you're probably wondering who will be replacing Pastor Antoinetta. So Robin, I'm going to ask you to come forward as our bishop and cabinet have discerned.
Good morning. So once again, I have a letter from our district superintendent, Pastor Dan Morley, which I will read to you. It says, "Grace and peace to you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Through prayerful discernment, the bishop and cabinet of the Desert Southwest Conference concur with your staff parish relations committee that the gifts and skills of the Reverend Mike Hubbard are fit to serve the needs of Green Valley UMC as associate pastor. Therefore, Robert Hoshibata intends to appoint Reverend Hubbard to begin serving as associate pastor on or before July 1, 2016. Reverend Hubbard has worshiped and served you for several years. You have been blessed by his presence and ministry. He will now step into the place of associate pastor in the quarter-time position of overseeing your ministry of congregational care." Every single time I tried that, I said congressional. Okay. "I look forward to worshiping with you on a Sunday soon to come. In the meantime, may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Blessings in Christ, Reverend Daniel R. Morley."
Thank you, Robin. And some of you already know Pastor Mike Hubbard. Actually, a couple weeks ago, I was on vacation as I was moving into a house, and Pastor Mike was here with Pastor Antoinetta. And so he will be taking over as our associate pastor here in a couple months. So I appreciate Robin sharing that. It's never easy for Robin to come up here and share these things, share what the bishop and the cabinet has discerned. So I invite you to keep Robin in your prayers. And when you see Robin around, she's always around, thank her for what she does. She has really a thankless job. And so really thank her if you would do that. Why don't we all rise, though, for our call to worship?
Love the Lord our God.
God,
the Creator. Our first scripture reading is from Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 through 3. "In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, 'Let there be light,' and there was light." The word of God for the people of God.
Thank you. Because of your love, we are here. Because of his love, we are here every Sunday, worshiping him and praising him. Let's pray. Father, thank you, Lord Almighty, for this beautiful morning. Thank you, Father, because at the beginning, the earth was disorganized. But you organized the earth for us, Lord, because you love us that much. And we believe it, Lord. We believe in every single word that is coming from you, Lord. Thank you, Father, because we are called to love you, to you alone, O Lord. We are called to love you with all our heart, with all our soul, and with all our might. Oh, Father, but because you love us first, that's why, Lord, you are asking us to love you all the time, to love our neighbors, Lord. Thank you. Thank you because we believe in you, because you first believe in us, Lord. We are your masterpieces. We are, Lord, your creation. We are, Lord, those who fell and you restored, Lord. We are those that sometimes trespass against others and others trespass against us. And you give us, oh Lord, forgiveness to our souls. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, that you are moving right here this beautiful morning. And before you, I present this prayer request. Your people are in the hospitals, back with illnesses, oh Lord, heart illnesses. Others alone, others, oh Lord, with a lot of problems. Others divorcing, oh Lord. Lord Almighty, we know that there is this time you are working in this prayer request. And we give you thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you.
Deuteronomy chapter 6, verses 4 and 5. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. You shall love the Lord with God, your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might. The word of God for the people of God.